Deputy Gerry Adams.
Gormagad Cancornia. Deny reality and truth, Shannon wrote a dirt to Bamacho Hen and Taishuk. Arahan Tehan, Rinshivsha, Alan Galantu. Akushinamako, Hanikshiv, Agurkt, Tashivsha, Egbrishu, Galant, and Ye Galanti. Taishuk, yesterday you chalked up yet another U turn. However you put it this morning, yesterday you abandoned your job's budget commitment. Yesterday we learned that the forecasts for growth have been cut to 0.5%. How much growth is that? Yesterday we learned that the government's budgetary targets of reducing the deficit.
It's leaders' questions.
Okay, Cara. By 2004 will be missed and won't even be met by 2016. You said not another red cent would go to the banks. You said that the bondholders will pay, then you give them $24 billion. You said you'd reverse the cut in minimum wage. Now you say you need the OK from the EU and the IMF. You said you'd review the universal social charge. Now you're briefing on a bigger burden on those on lower and middle incomes and those on welfare. You promised to put the EU
Could
IMF...
Could we have the question, please?
Yes, I'm coming to that, John Cordia.
Thank you.
Interest payments on the agenda at the EU summit. Then you backed down. You took it off. You came here and boasted that that was your initiative. And now we're being told through the media that there's going to be a revised memorandum of understanding to be published on Friday, with no doubt in my mind that this will have more cuts and more austerity. Now, Taoiseach, we know that this state and you in government inherited an economic crisis created by the last government, but they're not in government now. You're in government. You're making the political choices, and with respect, you're making the wrong political choices.
We have the question.
How do you continue to lumber the Irish people with a colossal debt, which we cannot afford, to reinforce and keep buying into an EU-IMF deal, which we cannot afford? And how do you hope to continue to cut your way out of recession when it's patently obvious that this situation is not sustainable?
Thank you, Deputy Taoiseach.
Well, Deputy, I do live in the land of truth and reality, and in fact there are elements of the first that you could deal with yourself. However, you've mentioned about the review of the universal social charge. As you know, the government have signed off on a detailed and comprehensive spending analysis for every government department. For the first time ever, that we'll get a real view in respect of the value for taxpayers' money and how it's being spent by ministers. And that's the reason why the Department of Finance is now split into two separate departments. And Minister Brendan Howland will be dealing with the issues of public expenditure and public reform. So that when we come to preparation of the details of the budget for 2012, the universal social charge will be included in that review as is part of the programme for government. You will realise that we can't review it until such time as that comprehensive analysis is actually carried out. Now, you mentioned about the minimum wage. This is a commitment of the programme for government. There are two views here. The Minister for Enterprise could do that by ministerial order or by primary legislation. The advice that we have is that it's best to do it by primary legislation because of the fact that it may well be challenged. But the minimum wage of itself is not the only issue here. There are other issues of restrictions on employers and the freeing up of the labour market that will be taken in conjunction with that. There's a review pending in 2 weeks' time. And together, when that review is available, the Minister for Enterprise will move in respect of that as a package. You mentioned about the growth rates and the projections there being reduced. This, as you know, came from a comprehensive analysis by the IMF of 57 countries. They did criticise the US and others for not doing enough. They did say that Europe was making progress. I can confirm to you that the meeting between the Ministers for Finance yesterday and the Troika was a very good meeting, and it's only right and appropriate and expected that the Memorandum of Understanding will be updated by this weekend when the Troika have finished their work here and their discussions with the Ministers for Finance. As you are aware, Deputy, projections for growth are very difficult to confirm even 6 months ahead, never mind 3 years ahead. That's why this government recognise that unlike the last government, you can't cut your way to prosperity and you can't tax your way to prosperity. You have to have a strategy for growth on the other side, because growing our economy is the only way that you can provide stimulus for people to get back to work, to provide stimulus so that the economy can grow, exports can increase, the value of what we produce in our country goes to providing the kind of economy that we want. So from your initial comment about Mujer Igor, the British guarantee, Tamuja Agro Nearing Gutcha, Agus the Hulla Denella, and you can be sure, Deputy, that whatever further discoveries we make in opening the doors of government and letting in the light, that we will tell the Irish people the true scale of the legacy that we have inherited.
Thank you. Deputy Adams.
To come here, Taoiseach, I heard in the media about the revised memorandum of understanding. I didn't hear it from you. And secondly, I think you're missing the point. I'm genuinely trying to understand your negotiating strategy. I'm trying to come to terms with exactly how you're trying to achieve the objectives that you have set out. And I don't understand it. And I'm sure that the Irish people don't understand it. What we need to know is this. Who's going to pay for this? Is it going to be the rich? Is it going to be those who earn over, and I know this isn't rich, but over 100,000? Is it going to be those on whom we can bring in a new third tax band? Or is it going to be lower and middle income families? Is it going to be the 500,000 people, 500,000 who are on the dole? Is it going to be people on social welfare? Is it going to be all those small people out there who elected you to bring about change? And what you're doing is doing exactly the same as this crowd did when they were in government, and the Irish people sorted them out.
Thank you, Deputy.
So, Taoiseach, we need to know who's going to pay for this, and try to explain this in terms that a wooden head like me can understand.
Thank you, Deputy.
What is your negotiating strategy?
Taoiseach.
Far be it from me to put a title on any deputy in here. Let me say this to you. The government's programme is in three parts: growth, job initiatives and a comprehensive review of how our money is spent. In respect of the European position, wooden head or none, I would say this. We have already set out the view that we believe that there should be an interest rate reduction. The heads of government meeting in Brussels agreed with my suggestion that as the bank stress tests were not published at the time here in Ireland and had not been completed, that it would only be appropriate that in the truth of those stress tests becoming available, that the Ministers for Finance at their next meetings should deal with this. And the informal meeting in Budapest the other day obviously was blown slightly off course by the fact that the Portuguese government have applied for funding under the scheme. The second element of that is that in the ESM structure agreed from 2013, what is important there is that the design of that scheme be appropriate for Ireland in respect of the capacity to provide medium to long-term funding for the country. That's where the emphasis has to be in respect of the European dimension to these discussions. So far from straying from what we said, we are targeted specifically on the elements of the programme for government that we've set out. You're not a wooden head, and you're raising this for political purposes. We've already said that where savings would occur, that we would be looking at the lower paid element of the public service and lower paid people. The best antidote to unemployment is a job and work and opportunity to have a career, and that's where the government is focused. I'd remind you that in our own budgetary presentations last year, we protected the blind, the children, the disabled and the pensioners. So I don't take it from you that you're even suggesting that this government would be focusing on the underprivileged or the vulnerable or the isolated.
Taoiseach.